Pick six.
Man, just a blessing. First and foremost, just thank God. Just going out there, have fun. But we're just man coverage, you know, locked up with the tight end. And then, you know, they've just been running screens all night. So, you know, I just kind of saw a different release than I'm used to. And I just, instead of really going and following my man, I just turned my head and ball kind of dropped in my face. I ain't gonna lie. So, thought Stafford was gonna catch me. I ain't gonna lie. My 40 time doesn't help when it comes to that. So, but definitely just very grateful. Just go out there with my guys and have fun. So. Screens are just, you can kind of smell a rat when it comes to those things. Just kind of very quick to the flat. You know, they've been doing it all night, again, trying to get cup. And I think they were just trying to get back on track, just trying to get things going. But just guys are just swarming. You know, defense is just playing lights out. I think we held them to 3 field goals, if I'm not mistaken. So just going out there and having fun and just do your 111.
What's going through your mind? You didn't exactly catch it clean. What's going through your mind as you're trying to secure it there?
Honestly, I think I read it too fast, almost. It almost like, I think I should have been a little bit more patient, maybe a little bit more secure to catch. Had a couple of those plays in college, actually, where I made the tackle on the play. So it's kind of like, I think I just read it too quick. But it's kind of similar to what Jimmy had last year, actually. So screen, pick, and he took it to the house as well, same sideline. So watch my film, I guess.
Jimmy Ward. That your confidence on the field is unusual for a second-year player. What is it about this team that allows you to be confident, or, you know, you as a player that you're so confident?
Honestly, you know, confidence is still building. You know, I couldn't tell you that each player on the team is fully confident. They keep you build it every game that you're in, you know, all the way until it's your last snap and your last game ever. But where I'm very fortunate, and I'm not trying to get all emotional and stuff, but I'm very fortunate to just have the staff. This organization is just a blessing to me. The guys on my team and on the sidelines, they continue to support me. You know, and Coach Kyle, he's just giving me a lot of confidence to go out there. So, you know, he says it in the meetings. I'm a young guy. I'm only 22, so I'm just got to keep going. You know, you're never satisfied and never get complacent, for sure.
That being said, I mean, what was the emotions, you know, coming through for your team in a close game? Really, it was a one-possession game before your pick six, so.
Honestly, we just got to go out there, and when you do your job, you know, I think that's something that I've learned this offseason. You know, you want to be results-driven. Everybody's results-driven. We got to get an interception, got to get a TFL. But, you know, being around Troy, it's just been a blessing because, you know, he sees it from a very different perspective. You know, when you really look at each play and you just do your job on each play, you know, things will be great things will happen, whether you set somebody else up for an interception, set somebody else for a sack. And if we have great coverage in the back end, we can let our front end and Bosa and Sanson and all those guys, they can just hunt the quarterback. And so we just had a great time out there and just have fun and just bring the energy, for sure.
How many times did they do that concept or that play that you got the pick on?
Well, they set it up different ways. You know, it's not just two. I think it was 2x2, and that's it. Different times, they'll go 3x1, put cup at one, cup at two. They set it up. They just kind of setting up how the offense wants to flow throughout the game. I think it's a good drive starter for them as well. So they're just trying to get a few yards just to kind of get momentum going, whether they want to quick count us and do all those things. But you just have to have great eyes. You know, if you trigger and have no hesitation, you can really make those plays, for sure.
And then, when you saw Debo's touchdown, were you thinking that play could be coming from the other side soon? I mean, that's basically the same play, wasn't it?
I guess so. Man, Debo, what, did he take one of those to the house, I think?
Yeah.
One of those, right? Yeah.
Screen.
Did he take it to the crib?
He took it to the
other one. All I know is I was on the sideline making adjustments, so I didn't see. I apologize. I apologize.
Couple more.
Well, we knew it was going to be an ice bag game. You know, I hear this word. I never heard that word until I got here, honestly. I love the word, actually, because it's cool. But every time we play these guys, it's a physical matchup. And so for us as a defense, we want to be the rock. You know, we want to be solid on defense, and we want to stand our ground and just go out there and swarm. You know, when you swarm around the ball and the guys are just flying around, it just makes football so much more fun. So it's a blessing just to be on this defense and be a part of it. You know, whether I'm on the sideline cheering on my guys, I just want to do my job and everything I can. So D'Amico is a heck of a coach and a heck of a person as well.
You get for two of the highest ranked safeties right now in the league. What has he been like for you in this short time, and what are you going to look like when Jimmy comes back?
Both great safeties. First off, you know, like, honestly, Gip just got here about, I think, a month and maybe 5 weeks. And his first weekend, I was like, man, this guy has such a knack for the ball, a knack for the game. And I'm so young and I got a knack for just bringing energy. And so I kind of always think, like, when he brings the knowledge and I can bring the energy and we just go out there and just have fun, you know, I think it's year 11 for him, I believe. And he's just going out there playing like he's 22, like, and he's like 23 and just having a great time. So we're it's contagious and we just feed off each other. And it's just been a pleasure just being right by his side as well. So
were you tonight with D'Amico Ryan's play calling? It seemed like he called pressures at all the right time. They were effective.
Man, he was just, I ain't gonna lie, it was a sweet. It's awesome just being a back end and have a guy like D'Amico just call things up. You know, sometimes you just, as a safety, you don't know what he's gonna call, you know, whether he wants you to be more patient, you know, whether he wants you to be a little bit more aggressive. But I think it was just outstanding. I think we just knew what we had to do when we got into the red zone. I think that's where we really kind of want to clean up areas and make sure we don't want to give up points. 3 points is cool, but if at the end of the day, if we can just hold them to zero, we can go back in this film and just and relook at it. But definitely just great play calling for sure.
All right, guys, that's it.
Thank you guys so much. Appreciate it.